Hello, my name's Des Shipp, and I've brought you to a fantastic fishery today called Packington Somers. It's right in the middle of Birmingham by the NEC. It's a beautiful fishery, and at last, the sun's shining. And I've brought you here today to show you how to catch more fish on the new Banjo XR feeder. First thing we're going to go through is the setup, and it doesn't get any easier. It is very, very similar, if not the same setup as the Method feeder. Now, because I'm fishing packing today, this is like a big snake lake and it's quite wide. I would say it's probably 40 meters wide to the far bank. So I'm going to use a Sapira 10 foot, 30 gram, which is going to get me over there. And talking to John, who runs the fishery, he did say the F1s aren't really feeding, but there is some absolute proper big carp having a go. So straight away in my mind, we are probably gonna have to catch some big carp today, and we got the perfect setup. So anyway, I've got a 420 centrist reel loaded up with 8 pound sinking feeder mono. 8 pounds gonna cover me for all the up lengths I'm gonna be fishing today. And it's straight down to one of the new Banjo feeders. And it's as simple, it's just free running. I've got a free running one on today. Like I said, 8 pound, straight through like that. Got me little quick change bead, and I've got one of the new KKHB hooks on. It's a size 14. I've just got them out of the packet like that. Sorry, size 16. 019, I've just taken one of them on. We're gonna be starting on bandoms. You know, I've got the option of changing up baits, but bandoms are gonna be the main thing today. I've just taken one of the pre-tied off of there, and it's done. That is as simple as that. I've actually clipped up already, so I actually cast out without an hook length on. Don't start doing that with a hook length on, because there is a few reeds and that about. So I've just cast out an empty feeder at the start, and we're ready to go. So I've got clipped up, probably fishing a meter off the far bank, meter and a half off the far bank, and then I'll just start fishing and then maybe move right up tight to the far bank as the session goes on. Bait for today is lovely and simple. I've got some 2mm fishery pellets. It's one of the biggest things I get asked, whether you're fishing with a Method or with a Banjo, Des, how long do you do your micros for? So whether you've got to use fishery pellets, and that's why I do it this way, because some of the fishery pellets you buy, they can be a bit funny about how long you soak them for. Now I've only soaked them for 30 seconds, and they will be a bit dry, but what I do then is have a little container of water on my side tray, and I'll just put a little bit of palm water in, just to get them dead right. But they need to be left, after you've soaked, they need to be left for about 20 minutes to half an hour, really. I've got some ground bait, some of my favorite ground bait, which is Match Method Mix. Again, really, really simple to mix. If you use 3 pints of ground bait to 1 pint of water, it's absolutely perfect. And I'll start on micros, because speaking to John this morning, like I said in the intro, you know, he thinks that the big carp could feed today because there's not a lot of F1s. I think they're probably getting ready to spawn. But ground bait on its day can be absolutely, it's a game changer. You know, we know how good it is when you're fishing down the edge sometimes on the pole, and that's exactly the same on the feeder. I've got my favorite bandoms, and I'll catch millions of fish on these. I've got some of the Scopex bandoms there. We've got a selection of different colors. We've even got some little ones in there, which have got a little bit of the red fleck in them. So there's all sorts of different, I've got some other bands with me, but they smell absolutely beautiful. So I got them, and I've also got maggots, because like I said, it doesn't matter whether you're fishing with a Banjo XR feeder or whether you're fishing with a normal Method feeder, always take a few dead maggots with you. You never know on the day, putting 2 maggots on, especially midday when things go a bit quiet, you can carry on catching. It might not be the big fish, but you might get some F1s, some skimmers, and then when the carp start feeding later in the session, you can just go back to fishing with the bandoms. So that's the bait. Let's get it on the side tray and then I'll start fishing. Right, first cast of the session. I'm going to show you now how to actually load this new Banjo XR feeder. I'm going to start on 2mm. That's what I normally do. So that's what I'm going to start today. I've put a tiny little bit of water on them now, so you can just actually bind them together. Absolutely ideal for the feeder. It comes with a mold. So I've got my mold like that. Now you've got to reverse this mold on the Banjo feeder. It's got to be the opposite way round. And I'll show you for that in a minute why that is. So I'm going to put I'm going to fill the mold up, probably just 3/4 like that. Put my hook bait in the middle. Put the line out through the little gap and then put some more 2mm pellets on the top. I'm just going to make sure there's plenty of bait. And what you actually got to do, because you want the line coming out the same way like that, that's why you've got to reverse it. So it is, you've got to bear that in mind with the new XR feeders, you have to do that. So put it in the mold, little press button, and it comes like that. And then if you want to, and I'm going to start on, I'm actually going to fill the mold back up again halfway and pack it a little bit more. So you've got plenty of bait on there like that. And that's what these feeders fly absolutely like an arrow. So I'm going to give that a little squeeze. I've picked my spot out there. Give that a nice cast, hold it back a bit. And like I said, I'm going to start a little bit off the bank. You can, I normally do that on islands. If I don't know the venue and there's some big carp about, sometimes you can catch some great big carp fishing just in that slightly deeper water. You might have to go into the far bank. I'm just holding my rod down like that until the line sinks. Get it on your butt rest. A little bit of a tweak. So there's a tiny, tiny little bit of tension in the tip, and that's it. I've not got my stopwatch out yet. It's always nice to use a stopwatch like that, and you can learn. You might not learn anything for a little while, but as the day goes on, we might, if the fishing, you know, you might get a bite every 5 minutes, you could get it every 10 minutes, and that's really important, because what I don't want to do is leave the feeder out too long. That's the most important thing when I'm using a stopwatch and feeder fishing like this, is I don't leave it out too long. I can recast, or, you know, I can fish several spots on this lake today. I've got a nice peg. I can fish 2 or 3 areas, you know, so we might get 1 or 2 bites out of an area, and we might have to cast in a different area. And using a stopwatch, that does help massively. So I'm gonna watch me rod, because I would have fought some of the bites today are going to be proper aggressive, and let's hope that we get a few early bites. Well, there you go, that took 6 minutes for my first cast. It's only a small fish, I think. I'm not sure what yet, but I don't mind that, you know, just to get an early bite, that's the main thing. So what I do is take my back wind off straight away, so I can actually, because I like playing fish off the handle. I do have my clutch set as well, but that's sort of an extreme. Oh, it's a skimmer. But I don't mind, just to get a bite. Oops, not very good netting. Then I put the back wind on then. Put the rod under your butt. And your hands free. I'm just going to actually put in back, because we're not going to put them in the net today. So just make sure your hook length's all nice and clean. It's got no snot on it, any slime. And then go through the same process. But like I said, with the mold, with the banjo, it has to be round the opposite way. So that's how the feeder would normally fit in, like that. But to load it, you need it round the other way. So put it in backwards before you fill it. So I'm going to go through the same process again. 3/4 fill the mold. Smack some pellets over the top. Then you turn the mold round the right way so it takes the feeder like that. And that's a 20 gram, I'm fishing a 20 gram feeder at the moment. Obviously there's all sorts of different sizes and weights that we do. But I do like 20 grams, especially when there's a few F1s about. I think the lighter the feeder, the better for the F1s. So I'm going to cast that back out the same sort of area. And hit the clip, drop it in. Just hold the rod up like that. As long as that line's sinking, that's all I'm really worried about. If it stops, I'll just tweak the handle, just literally 1/2 inch, and you'll see the line coming together when it meets. That means that obviously all the line's sunk. like that. Just drop everything down and then just tweak the handle a little bit so that line's just going out to where we cast. Get your little stopwatch, reset that. You never know from one day to the next. Some days, you know, I think it's going to be it's a really funny time of the year at the moment. The fish are, there's a lot of cruising carp about. And when you get this sort of white fluffy stuff around, you always know it's that funny time of the year. Everything starts warming up and it might take a little bit of time to start catching. And we might just be fishing for the odd big fish. You never know. But just to get an early bite, I'm not fussed about that. You know, 6 minutes on the first cast. You can tell the time of year, all the birds are singing, it's absolutely beautiful. And I actually had a couple of little knocks before that as well. I thought any minute now I will get a bite, and it's literally 30 seconds later and I caught that skimmer. But I've got me a little bit of water there. I'm going to put a little bit, them pellets, just if they dry out, literally sprinkle a bit of water on your pellets. Just turn them around a little bit. You'll be surprised. Just that tiny little bit of water gets everything back again. Just that, amazing. And you can keep them pellets going, I think, for a lot longer. If you soak them for too long, for me personally, I find it like, I just feel like the pellets are coming off as the feeder hits the water. Where if you do it my way, I just think you get a lot more sort of control of the pellets going in, staying on your feeder. You can put them on soft, you can put them on hard. Where if you soak them for that little bit too long and they're sort of mushy, I think you just sort of limit it. You're limiting yourself what you can do with the pellets on the feeder. Well, I got my second bite now. I got my second bite, but I've actually cast out like three times. So that's all right. Feels like an F1. There's some massive F1s in Packington. Absolutely, they've caught me over double figures. This one, it ain't certainly this size. But it's fighting all right. Well, actually, it's a bit bigger than what I thought that. I think it's an F1. Hopefully it's a carp. It is a carp, so that's brilliant. Actually, I thought that was an F1. I actually come off the island. It wasn't a brilliant bite either. It was sort of a bit of that, and it just went completely slack. So it's obviously had me bait and then come back off the island. Probably 6 pound, I would have thought. Let's get him around here. That's brilliant. And that's took 5 minutes, that bite. God, dear me, he's going mental now. I'm not going to hold him up because he's got the right ump. Let's get him back. God, steady, woo. So that's brilliant. Nice little Packington mirror. Keep going on that for a minute. Make sure you get that, there's a bit of that white stuff about off the trees. You've got to make sure you get that off your lines. I actually caught that one as well on one of the Scopex red pellets. Like that. I'm always change around a bit at the start. So load me feeder up. Thing is, with a banjo feed as well, you've got options of putting your hook bait in different areas of the feeder, but normally I just put them in the middle. Let's get that back out. That was on that right hand line. I've not really changed anything yet. It's still early. Goes in absolutely lovely. That's the thing with the banjo feed, you can actually cram it on there because you've got like the little ridges coming up around the side. It stops it from spilling off. And that is the difference between like a banjo feeder and a method feeder. you get a little, I think you've got a bit more leeway of actually keeping the bait on the feeder. Just tweak that a little bit. And I said, literally, the line off the end of the tip now is going to where I cast, and that's as much tension as what you need. You don't need to have your tip crank right round. As long as that line, and you've got a tiny little bit of bend in the tip, that's enough pressure. And like I said, I'm only fishing 20 grams. Partly because if I do start catching F1s, I think 20 grams is the perfect weight for F1s, because they are, you know, they really fight hard. And I think if the less weight you've got banging around on top of the fish, you've got less chance of pulling the hook out. So I do try, especially venues with F1s and skimmers in, I do try and fish 20 grams. But normally, if I'm carp fishing in open water up against islands like this, I normally stick with a 30 gram. 30 gram is the all-rounder to me. Well, straight away, 1 minute, just under 2 minutes, that one. Might be an F1 this time. So I've took my back wind off straight away. It was a proper aggressive bite, that. So that was on a little red pellet. So that was actually a faster bite on a red bandom. Oh, that's a beautiful F1, that. And you always find that on certain days, a certain colour and a certain size normally gets you more bites. He's just flicked that off in the landing net, that caught. Dear, he's not very happy. Tough as old boots, these things. Look at that. Great big Packington Somers F1. Absolute animals in here. You see the feeder on there? Let's get him back, get another one. So that was real quick. If we can get them going, that'd be brilliant. Just get another one of those red Scopex pellets out. They're quite a nice red as well. They're like a dark red. 6 mil I'm putting on. Got me feeder already loaded up. Saves a little bit of time when you're catching. When you start catching really fast, load that up, crush your bait down a little bit. And then just give it a nice, you can do what you want there, you know what I mean? I'm crushing it on quite hard at the moment. Back out again, hit the clip, down. The art of it is to hit that clip and not to try and bounce the feeder back towards you. It's something you've got to practice. And if you come to somewhere like Packington, I mean, I could come here, I live quite away from Packington, but if I wanted to actually come here and practice method feeder fishing, this is the perfect venue for it. There's another F1. These are starting to come on strong now. Now I've changed over to fishing with maggots, so I started getting indications on my tip quite often. I was getting it odd on the bandom, so I've just changed over now to maggot with the 50-50 micros and ground bait. But the next stage is, I think, is putting neat ground bait on. So that's what I'm going to do now, because I think personally that ground bait, just putting that 50-50 mix in, has got some fish in me peg. And when you start getting these little indications, these F1s, they ain't playing ball today, they're really crafty, and that's what I'm looking for. So I'm putting double. All I've done is taken the band off the hook that I was using, just cut the band off and just putting two dead maggots on, and I'm just going to put neat ground bait on now. It's a simple process again, just 3/4 of that mould up. And that's what's so good about that Banjo feeder. You can go from, like I said, it works with ground bait, micros like that, loads perfectly with the mould. And I've actually gone over a little bit closer to the island as well. Like that. Beautiful, that. It's quite deep. It's quite deep over there. You've actually got a bit of a count on the feeder. But there is definitely a shelf there. So I've got to go really careful because it is quite a steep shelf. And I've actually fished on Molam's Lake here at Packington a couple of times. And there's some pegs where I think the island is sort of been et away over the years, the erosion. And it's quite shallow, quite a long way out from the island. But on this peg, it seems like the shelf, yeah, look at that, look. And that's ground bait. Oh, get out of there. And that is exactly, and I said to Joe who's filming today, once I started getting knocks, I said, I bet you I end up on ground bait. And this is one of them days. And even John, the guy who runs it here, John, he's a lovely guy, come round and said, well, no one fishes ground bait on the method on here. And they're missing a trick, believe you me. It's happened so many times to me. It doesn't matter whether it's winter, summer. And that just proves straight away. They're so funny some days, especially F1s. I mean, as we go along, unfortunately, the weather's changed. It's actually raining again, believe it or not. And I've actually put my hoodie on because it's actually got a lot colder. But this ground bait, I'm sure now, will make a huge difference. Feels like a big F1. No more carp at the moment, but I'm sure they'll come on later. Still got the fluff coming off the trees. Oh yeah, look at that, great big Packington F1. I said, John said to me earlier, you know, they catch F1s and you're now £10. I mean, I'd love to see an F1 £10. I've caught them up to sort of £7, but £10 F1 is ridiculous. But that's sort of an average size that for in this venue. Nice fish though. Beautiful. Look at that, like a bronze. Look at that, absolutely stunning. Built like concrete they are. It's lovely fish, I really enjoy it, especially when you chuck into an island. Let's get him back. And I'm just gonna keep going now, keep going on that. Because I think what happens is, the ground bait, there is some food there, but really, that's why fish get so sort of involved with ground bait, because it just melts off the feeder and there's nothing else there for them to pick up really. And it just gets them fired up. Let's do go for that again. So 3/4 of the mold. Didn't even have time to set me stopwatch that cast. Some days the micros just keep going. And then other days like today, they've gone a bit funny. We caught some nice big carp on micros. Give that a nice good squeeze. And then with them sides on that new Banjo, so you can get that ground bait right in there. Hook bait's perfectly buried. And they cast absolutely arrow straight. I said, just got to go really careful. Still got a fish quite heavy because, like everywhere I'm fishing at the moment, the fish fight so hard. I mean, that sort of kited to the left. If it would have touched them reeds with lighter lines, I think you'd have got seen off. So just a slight little, get that line. And I'm watching for little indications. And I just started, once we caught a couple of big carp, caught that like 6-pounder, a couple of big F1s. And then all of a sudden, it's these little tiny indications. And I said to Joe, that's either skimmers or really crafty F1s. And I honestly thought it was skimmers. And I changed over to the 50-50 with the bandom, caught a couple of big F1s. And then I started getting indications and couldn't really catch. So I had to keep casting. And then I changed over to maggot, caught a few. And I thought, today at the moment, this ground bait will catch us more fish, which is what's happened. Well, that literally hit the bottom and never even had time to actually tighten up the line. One of the smaller F1s in here, but that just sums up the power of ground bait. Even with the Banjo feeder. Let's get the net off of him there. So I'm gonna carry on. Unfortunately, it's time for you guys to go. I've had a fantastic day. I've caught some absolute, well, I've had a couple of great big carp, plenty of F1s. I hope you've picked up some great tips on how to fish with the new Banjo XR feeders, and I'll see you on the bank sometime.